Uyghurs are a Turkic-speaking Muslim minority in China, living mostly in the sensitive frontier province of Xinjiang.
And the Chinese government has been treating them absolutely terribly.
We've been waking up to horrific stories every day, heartbreaking images separating mothers from their children.
They live in a police state, where they're monitored by one of the most advanced and intrusive surveillance systems in the world.
Imagine that the police force you to stand in front of a camera for biometric data collection.
Every online activity is tracked.
Imagine that the police force you to install a spying app on your phone.
Their religion is restricted. Many traditional Muslim names are even banned for newborns.
Party officials are frequently attacking Islam as very old-fashioned, very backward.
These are some of the suspected detention camps where an estimated 1 million Uyghurs are held. Many of them have not been heard from since being detained.
And look, if that weren't enough to make it clear what these camps really are, just listen to one former detainee describe what she went through.
Each woman gets 2 minutes to go to the toilet. They tell you to be quick, quick, quick. If you're not quick enough, they shock you with an electric baton on the back of your head. It really hurt, and they did it a lot. Even after being shocked, we had to say, "Thank you, teacher, we will not be late next time."
She was in two different camps, then was transferred into forced labor at a glove factory, all while separated from her family for 2 years. And while they were eventually reunited, they are understandably still haunted to this day.
For 2 years, you didn't see your mom?
Uyghur Kazakhların öldüğü yerleştirildi de. Şu sebepten numusku çidemegan ayarlarımız neticesi ölüvağallar var.
All you guys spent time in the camps. I mean, what was your crime? What were you each taken in for?
Kur'an okuğandım hem Arap dili öğrengendim aşın için. Devlet parçalaş korunğan dep kolğağan.
Kişen de putum di kişen bilen 1 yıl 3 ay 10 gün çıkıkça men aş kişen bilen putum di kişen bilen jürdüm 5 kiloluk kişen.
Her birisimizin birden açıqıp suraqqa başqmış. Öyle yandı köyde çiğkırgan avaz çiketti, tayaqnın avaz.
Uyghur sözü sak kim Uyghur sözü atıdı deple karanlık.
If you were caught speaking Uyghur, you were locked up in a dark room. We also had to write out lines of praise to the Chinese Communist Party. Every 10 days we had to stick our arms through to get an injection. We didn't know what it was, but the younger women stopped having their periods. We had to do sit-ups in the nude. It didn't matter if you were 14 or 84. That's how they violated our honor.
In 2015, ethnic Uyghur Mihrigul Tursun, then a citizen of China, gave birth to triplets in Egypt, where she'd been living and working.
We're Elena. We're Elena.
It's me.
And barely a month later, she flew home with them to Xinjiang, a region of Western China. At the airport, she says Chinese police detained her and took away her babies.
I asked her, "Where is my baby? Please give me my baby." Then they
taped your mouth.
Yes.
Mihrigul says police jailed and interrogated her for the next 3 months. The day of her release, she went to the children's hospital in Urumqi to see her infants.
When I come hospital, doctor said, "Okay, my baby can go outside hospital." He said, "Yes, he died." I looked at him, "What? What died?" He said, "Your son died yesterday morning 6 o'clock. I don't believe it." And I scream, "Why you kill my son?" And they say, "If you scream, I call police. Stop. Be quiet."
They forced us to take unknown pills and drink some kind of white liquid. The pill caused us to lose consciousness and reduced our cognition level. The white liquid caused loss of menstruation in some women, and extreme bleeding in others, and even death. I also experienced torture in a tiger chair the second time I was detained. I was taken to a special room and placed in a high chair. Bands held my arms and the legs in place and tightened when they pressed a button. The guards put a helmet on my shaved head. Each time I was electrocuted, my whole body would shake violently and I could feel the pain in my veins. I thought I would rather die than go through this torture. I begged them to kill me. I witnessed 9 deaths in my cell in 3 months. I cannot imagine how many deaths there must be in all the camps.
Bizni her haftada kamerdan kamerga yetkaydi. Biroq bir kamerda men bir hafta turdim. Shu haftada tug'an vaqtda endi qizlar so'raqqanda kuniga 2dan 3dan qizlar so'raqqa chiqib ketdi. Osha so'raqdan kirgan qizlar hammasiniki mundaq 10 pulni jig'ilgan tiqib timoqlarini elib, qizlarni hammasi badanlari ko'kirib kamer yo'q ya batalada. Shu osha ochiqib qazoq balsi 27 yoshli bola osha sen de yaxşılığını bilmeysen ki, yaxşılıkçı biz şunca kisaksan bilmeden hem de kızı hem de kör sözü bir şey yaptı. Orup, ben orup ki nasıl ki işten ne işe bana, tüm üstelik kullarımız işe bana işten ne işe bana koydu ki nasıl ki. Ne oldu? Sen Allah yok.
They were 3 men.
Üçü.
Not one, but 3.
Üçüz.
They did whatever evil their mind could think of, and they didn't spare any part of my body, biting it to the extent that it was disgusting to look at. They didn't just rape, they were barbaric. They had bitten all over my body. They had an electric baton. I didn't know what it was. It was pushed into my private parts and I was tormented with electric shocks.
Balalarım boyu ailem hepimiz gibi girip meninki çıktı, Muhammed'den çıktı, yoldaşımınki, şu üç öğleninki burun çıktı, kalan beş balamınkini çıkarıp vermedi. Kızımınki dünyaya hayat tokluşunu, beni Hıhtay'ın kolu ölüp gitmesini ensirip, yenip gelgen balalarımdan ağırlık. Çıkıp kesse bir 15-20 günün içinde ballarım bile yüz görüşüme dep çıkan. Lakin ameliyatı onda bulmadı. Bir kadın ballarım bile karanlık burası çıkıp kalsa ben şunu deyim ben. Mesela ben bir gün mü ağırlığı kalamayım ben. Ben her gün mü ballarımı taşı etmeyim ben.
Those women and those children and those old men that are being thrown in jails, they're our fathers. There are children. There are, but they are bond to them is La ilaha illallah, which is thicker than blood.
We might not see the light at the end of the tunnel. We might not see the Uyghurs fully freed. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not create us to see that. Allah created us to do whatever we can, so that when we meet Him, we can say, "Oh Allah, this is what I did about the Uyghur situation." And perhaps in that is our salvation.